H2K Infosys provides world-class online IT training, staffing and software testing solutions to customers worldwide. H2K Infosys supports 100% job-oriented training, hands-on project work, cloud test lab, resume preparation and review, mock interviews, robust syllabus. One-time pay, lifetime access to live classes and videos. H2K Infosys has won the trust of thousands of students worldwide. For free demo class, visit h2kinfosys.com.
Participants, this is Priya here from H2K Infosys. And I'm a senior automation tester with 9+ years of experience in this IT field. I started my career as a .NET developer and then I changed my career to QA after moving to US. So this is my introduction, participants. Now, all the participants, you can write your introduction in 2 lines on the chat box. All right. All the participants, please write your introduction in 2 lines on the chat box. Just about your education and your experience background. 2 things only. Write your education and experience background on the chat box. I'll wait for a minute. Okay, so participants, I see that most of you are from non-IT background. Fine. So this is a QA or the software testing course that we are conducting, participants. And then the sessions that we have scheduled. So it's going to be 4 days session that we have scheduled, wherein we are going to discuss about the projects. With the testing perspective. So here these are the different topics. Day one, we'll understand some basics about the software testing. But since most of you have mentioned that you're from non-IT background, I'll discuss little bit basics about the software development as well. And then we will have a look at the practical exercises using the tools. We'll have a look at the real life scenario with the real time examples, which will be project based. So I'll show you with a project based example on how to do the testing and then why the QA is required, the market requirement. And then we'll have a look at the courses that are offered by H2K Infosys. And then what is the combination of the course that you have to take based on the background that you have mentioned. So participants, this will be the schedule for the next 4 days. For the project-based sessions that we are conducting over here. So these are project-based sessions that we are conducting. And all the participants, I think among you there are some people who are from different batches. So for all of you this week, we'll be having the project-based sessions that will be conducted and it will definitely help you for your understanding the QA course better, and also it will help you to find the jobs and perform the jobs. All right, participants. So this will be the schedule for next 4 days. Now, participants, before I proceed further, we'll discuss little bit of basics. Okay. So we'll start with the first topic, that is understanding the concepts of the software testing. But before I take up the concepts about the software testing, I would like to just give you some brief introduction to this IT industry. So participants, I guess all of you understand what is the meaning of software. It is a set of programs that is developed for specific purpose. And then we have several examples of the software here. Like we have the Gmail, the Microsoft Office tools, internet banking application, online shopping sites, the mobile applications, the billing systems in Walmart and Macy's. All these are different examples of the software. These are the different examples of the software. And participants, in order to develop the software, we follow various steps. Okay. In order to develop the software, we follow various steps and we call it as SDLC, the software development lifecycle. life cycle, which is a step-by-step approach to develop the software. So here, participants, we basically start with scope identification, or in this phase, there is a person called as a business analyst who will meet the client in order to gather all the project related information. So we have the business analyst here who will meet the client and gather all the project information. And then, participants, we have the project planning, which will be done by the project manager. And then we have the analysis phase here. So analysis is done by the business analyst, wherein the detailing of the requirements is done. Then we design the software, and this task is done by an architect. And then comes the development. So development is done by the developers. Then we have the testing. Testing is done by the QA. And after this, participants, we release a software. Technically, we call it as a deployment. So here we have the developers, the system administrators, and then participants, we have the user acceptance testing, wherein the real-time users are testing the software. They are checking if the software is meeting their requirements. So participants, these are the different steps that are to be followed in order to do the software development. And you can see here, participants, once the software is ready, as a QA, you are supposed to do the testing. So testing comes after the development. So testing is one of the step, you can say, which comes in the software development life cycle. And only after you have done the testing and made sure that everything is working properly, I mean the software is working properly, then we release it to the client. So without the approval of the QA team, the software cannot be released to the client. So now, participants, what exactly is this testing? See, testing is all about identifying the defects in the software. Identify the defects in the software and verify the compliance to client requirements. Okay, so this is how we define the testing. Testing is all about identifying the defects in the software, and we should also make sure that we are meeting the requirements of the client. So this is how we define the testing. And every software that is developed, it should be tested for the quality. And who does the testing? It is done by the QA. This person could also be called as a software tester. So here, participants, testing is done by the QA. Now, there are so many different types of testing. There are different ways of testing, all right? And then there are different testing tools that are available. So there are different ways in which we could do the testing. Now, participants, you can note down this one, the meaning of software, and then the steps to be followed in order to do the software development. You can also make a note of the definition of the testing. Just some quick notes, participants, for your review purposes. I'll wait for a minute. Please make your notes quickly. Or else, if you want, you can simply take a screenshot and save it on your computer. Najmul, if you want, we can share it. So participants here, in the software development life cycle, I guess all of you have understood that the testing comes after the development phase. And also, before we release a software to the client, we need to do a very thorough testing on the software. All right, the software has to be tested thoroughly to check for the defects. And also, we should make sure that we are meeting the requirements of the client. Not required as of now, Ismail, but once you join the QA course with us, how to install, what to install, I will tell you. So here, participants, I will give you the broad classification of the testing. See, testing can be classified into the static testing, and then dynamic testing. And the dynamic testing is further classified into the white box testing, and then black box testing. The white box testing is further classified into unit or the component testing, and then we have the integration testing. Then we have the black box testing here. So here we have the system testing. Then we have the UAT, the user acceptance testing. And here, participants, we have the alpha testing and then the beta testing. Okay, UAT, that is user acceptance testing, is further classified into alpha and beta testing. So participants, in the static testing, we review all the project documents to identify the errors. Then we have the dynamic testing, wherein we run the actual software and we check for the defects. White box testing, particularly we are focusing on the programs here. Black box testing, not the programs, but then we are executing the actual software and then we are testing it. So the first two types, participants, these are done by the developers. System testing is done by the QA. User acceptance testing is done by the users. So here in the alpha testing, participants, the testing is done in the IT environment by the real users. And then beta testing is done in the client environment or the real environment by the real users. So here, participants, this entire QA course is all about system testing. So as a QA, you need not do any kind of white box testing. UAT is anyways done by the users, but as a QA, you can provide your assistance here. And then participants, the system testing is basically the one that is to be done by the QA. So in the courses that are conducted here by the H2K Infosys, we'll be focusing mainly on the system testing. What are the different testing tools that are used in order to do the system testing? What are the different types of system testing? So all the details about the system testing will be discussed in our entire QA course. Yes, Ismail, you'll be using the different kind of softwares and we will assist you. So participants, if you want, you can make note of this one. Just some quick notes for your reference. Be focusing mainly on the system testing. So participants, this is a broad classification of the testing. Is it similar to verification as static? Yes, Deepak, it is similar. So participants, here we have the different levels of testing. Testing can be static testing, dynamic testing, and here we have the white box testing, black box testing, unit or the component testing, and then we have the integration testing. Then in the black box, we have the system testing and then the user acceptance testing. So this is our test levels. These are the different levels in which the testing can be done. And participants, in order to do the testing, we have two different ways. You can do the testing either manually using the skills of the software tester, or it could be done automatically using the software. So we have the two different types of manual testing here. One is manual, two ways in order to do the testing, the manual testing and then the automation testing. So if you want, you can just make some brief notes on this, the two ways of testing and then the two levels of testing. See, Deepak, the verification and validation concepts are actually different. More about that we'll be discussing in detail in our QA courses. And Kessel, what is the manual testing? Manual testing means as a QA, you're supposed to do the testing manually with your skills. You have to execute the steps, enter the test data, and check if the software is behaving as per the expectation. So these are the two ways of testing. Now, in order to do the testing, participants, we have to follow the different steps. And in order to do the testing, we also have the testing team here. Okay. So I will tell you, participants, how this IT project team is organized. So here we have a project manager who is the head of this entire IT project team. And under the project manager, we have the business analyst team who meet the client in order to gather the project information. And then we have the team of architects who design the software. And then we have the team of the developers who do the programming or the coding. There is a team of the testers over here who test the software to release the software to the client. And then we have various other roles over here. So now, participants, if you particularly consider these group of testers, so in this group of testers, we have first of all the test manager. This role might not exist in all the projects because in some small projects, we may just have the test lead and not the test manager. But if the project is huge, if there are many testers, in order to manage all the testers, we create the different groups based on their roles and responsibilities that we assign. And then for each group, there could be a test lead and above them, there could be a test manager. So here, when I say QA, it all includes the automation testers, performance testers, entry level experience testers. Everybody is included here in this QA team. So participants, this forms your testing team. So in the testing team, you have the test manager first of all. And then you have the test lead. And then there are different testers here in the team, all the different groups of testers. All right. So this is our testing team. Now, participants, in order to do the testing, we have to follow certain steps over here. The testing steps, basically, first of all, we have to meet the client and gather all the, as a QA, you will take the documents from the business analyst, because the BA has already met the client to gather all the project information. So the same information which will be shared with the entire IT project team, and that also includes the QA. So we start with the test requirement gathering here. And then we have the, And then participants, we have the test planning and analysis. Then we have the test design. test, implementation, and execution. So participants, you should be able to see now. I've reshared my screen. Test, implementation, and execution. Defect reporting and tracking, and then we have the test closure. So do you see, participants, these are the different steps that we got to follow as a QA in order to do the testing. So more about these details again we'll be discussing in our QA course. So with the project based examples, I'll be able to show you how these testing steps are followed by the different testers in the team while they are doing the testing. So if you want, participants, you can make some quick notes on this. Shrim, currently you should be able to see two ways of testing, testing team and then testing steps. Shrim, if you still have the audio issues, you can re-log in or contact H2K Infosys. So participants, these are the different testing steps that are to be followed in order to do the testing. So now participants, in order to start the preparation for the testing, we need some reference document over here and we call it as a specification document. So you see here we have a client. From the client, the person called as a business analyst meets the client and gathers all the project related information. Means the requirements are gathered by the business analyst from the client. Client means they are the organization for whom we are developing the software. And then all these details will be shared with the entire IT project team. So we have the IT project team here, which includes again the project manager, the architect, the testers, the developers, everybody are included here in the team. So now participants, as a QA, if you have to do the testing, so first of all you need to understand the requirements of the client. So you can see here it's a first step, test requirement gathering. Why is it done? To make sure that all of you have the requirements with you using which you could do the testing. So first of all, participants, as a QA, you need to understand the requirements of the client. What exactly the client wants, you should be able to identify that. And all this information you get from the business analyst who is writing the requirements which are gathered from the client. And then participants, the document that we prepare here, I mean the VA prepares, is called as a functional specification document by the business analyst. And using these requirements as a QA, you will do the testing. So the first and foremost thing, participants, that you need to understand is, as a QA, you have to gather all the project information to start with the testing. So now participants, I will show you the sample document of specification, how exactly it looks like. So here you see, participants, this is how the specification document looks like. This is how the specification document looks like. So we have the Gmail login over here. Some sample applications are there, participants, using which we are going to do the testing. So as a QA, first of all, you need to have the clarity about the requirements if you want to start with the testing process. And then, participants, each of these steps will be discussed in very much detail once you start with the QA course from us. So if you want, you can make note of this one. So participants, do you see here on my screen? This is a sample application that could be used for testing purposes. And I'm going to paste it on your chat box. If you want, you can have a copy of it. So here, participants, do you see? This is a login for the internet banking application, the finance application I'm considering here. So you have to choose the type of location for this session. So you see here inpatient ward, outpatient, and then isolation, pharmacy, laboratory. So based on where exactly you want to do the testing, you have to select the location for the session. You have to select the location here. Now, for example, I select this outpatient clinic. Here it is asking me to enter the user ID and password. If you don't have the user ID and password, you can maybe create one. So I've sent the link on the chat box, participants. All of you, please save the link that I sent on the chat box. Please save the link. And you could use it for the practice purposes. Asma and Hari, it is on the chat box. It's on the chat box. FSD and BRD document are same, or it is prepared using the specification document. See, Harini, when the BA is meeting the client to gather all the project information, it could be in the form of BRD, and then later when the BA is explaining each and every requirement in detail, we call it as a specification document. So in order to log in, you got to enter the user ID and password. If you don't have, you can create one, because this is a sample application that I'm going to show over here. So participants, I've entered the user ID and password here. And before I click on the login, I have to select the location for the session. So I will start with outpatient and then click on the login button. So you see here, participants, there are different options that are available, different features that are available, using which I can have the control over the system. So this is a sample application, participants, and how this could be used for the testing, this I'll be discussing again in the future classes in very much detail. There are a lot of features and then the functionalities that are available. So as a QA, first of all, participants, you need to understand the requirements thoroughly, based on which it could be tested. The software could be tested. So participants, let's see how this exact concept works. Okay, you didn't receive the link, no problem. A participant, just give me one moment, I will send it once more. So here, participants, let's see how exactly the testing is done. So participants, here you can see we have the different types of testing. When the BA is meeting the requirements, when the BA is gathering the requirements from the client, the requirements could be of different types. It could be the different functionalities that are to be implemented in the software, or it could be the speed of the software, how many users will be using the software. So all the project related information is gathered from the client by the business analyst, and then it will be shared with the entire IT project team. So do you see here, participants, this was a sample application that I'm considering over here. All right. So as a QA, first of all, you need to understand all the requirements, and then based on which you could do the testing. So here, participants, let me make you understand the software testing concept. What is it all about? See, any software that is getting developed, it should be released to the client only after the testing is done. Otherwise, there could be defects in the software, and it can lead to the failure of the software. So participants, in order to develop the software, I mentioned, right, there are different steps to be followed. And in each of these steps, we have the different members who are present over here. So that forms our IT project team. So steps in the sense, the same, okay, software development life cycle, the same thing I'm talking about. And then we have the IT project team here, the business analyst, the project manager, and then the business analyst. We have an architect here, the developers who develop the software, and then the testing is done after this, and then we release a software to the client. Now participants, if we don't do the testing properly, it will result into the failure. And how are these defects introduced into the software? The defects are introduced into the software due to the errors that we commit. See, no doubt these are IT professionals, but then anyways, they cannot avoid the human errors or the mistakes. For example, let's say a BA is meeting the client, missing some information to be gathered. Due to an architect, there is some kind of flaw in the design. Developers are making the logical errors in the program. So due to this kind of various errors or the human mistakes, participants, the defects can be introduced into the software. And when we release a defective software to the client, the failure happens. So in order to avoid the failure, participants, we got to do the testing and then identify the defects in the testing. So here you see, participants, your role is to test the software to avoid the failure. So now let's come back to the basic concept of this testing, participants. So I mentioned to you right here, from the client, who gathers the requirement? The business analyst is gathering the requirements. And again, these are not just the functionalities or features to be implemented, participants. These are the different features of the software. Like, we have to test how many users are required, what is the performance, the security related details have to be checked, quality standards have to be verified. So as a QA, you need to verify each and every requirement that is mentioned to us from the client side, and then it should be released to the client after that. So participants, whatever information is gathered here from the business analyst, it will be shared between the different members of the IT project team, and then we have the QA team over here. So I will be particularly talking here about the, so this is a development team and then this is a QA team. So here we are particularly focusing on the software testing, as I mentioned to you. Now participants, as a QA, you're supposed to test the software. And then what are the steps to be followed? What data is to be entered? So all the details will be present here in this functional specification document. We call it as a functional specification document, the one that I just now showed you, the Word document, and it has all the details of the requirement. So both the developers and the QA will use that document. And then what the developer will do? The developer will take the requirements and they will develop the software. So do you see here, participants, on my left hand side, there is some sample application that is getting displayed over here. All right. So this is a sample application on which you're going to do the testing. Now, who has developed this software, participants? Obviously, it is done by the developers. So we have the developers in our IT project team who will take the requirements from the business analyst and then they take the specifications and then they are developing the software here. So now participants, whatever result you can see here on this application, we call it as a actual result. All right, so or you can also call it as an actual outcome. And as a QA, what you got to do is you prepare all the test case documents using the specification document again given by the business analyst. So basically it is like if you follow certain sequence of steps, if you enter certain test data values, all right, so you are going to get some expected or the predicted result. So here participants, we are not yet doing the actual testing, we are still doing the preparation for the testing phase. So we take all the documents from the business analyst and then we are going to prepare the different conditions or the scenarios that we are going to test. And we call it as a expected behavior. Now for example participants, let's say there is a functionality here. So this find patient record, it's a functionality. See, functionality is anything which can perform a particular task for us. For example, if you consider the login functionality, it will help you to log in into the bank accounts. If you consider the account summary, you click on the account summary link in your net banking, what happens? It will display the account summary for you. And then we have the fund transfer using which you can transfer the fund. So we call this as the functionalities, right? So now when you enter the valid user ID and password, it should log in into the account. So that is called as an expected behavior of the software. So how do you think the software should behave? The expectations will be identified and then they will be documented here by the QA. So participants, whatever steps are performed, you got to do that. And then you have to check whether this actual and then the expected results match. If they match, the result will be pass. Otherwise, the result will be fail. And whenever there is a failure condition, the software will go back to the developer and then they will have to fix up the defects. Is it clear, participants? So on my left side, what you see here, this software application, okay, this is for the hospital management system actually. The one that I'm showing, it's a real project of the the one that we have developed, it is for the hospital management system. So now if I click on this find patient record, it will open the page, right? So this is an actual software that is developed by the developer. Okay, expected means this includes the different test documents. You must have heard, right? Test case document and all. Yes. So those are the documents in which we write the steps, we write the expected behavior of the software. And how to prepare all such documents, again, I'll be helping you out with this in our regular QA classes. We'll consider the project-based examples, more project-based examples, in fact, and we will see how to create the different test documents in order to do the testing. So as of now, you can understand that participants, as a QA, you have to test the expected behavior of the software or the predicted behavior of the software against the actual software developed by the developer. And then you identify the result. So this is actually the whole concept of testing. Okay. What is the whole concept of testing? You have to verify whether the software is developed as per the client requirements or not. Okay. So you prepare the test cases with all the expectations and predictions, and then you compare it with the actual software developed by the developer to make sure that it is working as per the requirement. So participants, do you see this is a concept of testing which you can make note of? Kazi, there is no need to write your email address on the chat box. The details will be sent to H2K and then you can take it from there.
Thank you. Priya, I have just got... Priya, can I ask one question?
Yes, please ask. I think, you know, participants, here we have a host.
Okay.
And then, you know, I don't...
Yeah.
Because the host will be muting you. What you do is, please write your question here on the chat box and I'm having a look at the questions over here. Okay, participants. Just post your questions on the chat box, people. Because I think the host has put all of you on the mute and then one person can talk. And that will be me, obviously. So you can please write your messages on the chat box, okay? So I'm reading your questions on the chat box. Just now, I think somebody tried to speak. I just heard you partially. Mention your name and write your question on the chat box. See, regarding the materials and recordings, don't worry. You can contact H2K regarding that and they will assist you. And Rashmi, I will give you some more sample examples and then you can, I will also give you the user ID and password. Otherwise, you can create your own IDs and password and then, you know, you can use this sample application. Yes, Kazi, you'll be getting it. But as I mentioned, you have to contact H2K. So there is another question from Deepak. Which document we use to write test case, SRS or FRS? See, Deepak, SRS, FRS, the names are same. Okay, but then the content will be almost the same. What happens is, the names could be slightly varying when it comes to the different projects. In some projects, you call it as functional specification document, FSD. In some projects, you call it as SRS, but then we are referring to the same document over here. All right. So it will have the details or the specification of the requirements that are to be developed and then tested. And also in some projects, they don't even create the BRD. They directly create the specification document, which could be used to understand how the software should behave as per the expectations of the client. And then based on that, we do the testing. Yes, Kazi, we take the specification document in order to prepare our test documents. Yes, Shagufta, I will just paste it on the chat box and all of you can use it. Full form of SRS, Naresh, it is System Requirement Specification. System Requirement Specification. And in case if I miss any questions, participants, let me know on the chat box. What is the reference document that we use in order to prepare the test document? Kazi, it is called as a functional specification document, or you can simply call it as a specification document. Vidya, the BRD, requirement document, and specification document are different actually. Specification document is more detailed when compared to the BRD. Asma, yes, you may not be able to see the chat messages because they are directly sending to the presenter. That's why I'm reading the questions and then answering them. So participants, this is one sample application, the hospital management system. And then I could show you one more here. One moment, I could show you one more. So there is another link, participants, that I'm going to send to you on the chat box. This also is the demo version, the sample application which you can use. And here, do you see? They have also mentioned the username and password for you to log in. So I will log in as a demo here. And this is a finance-based application, participants. It is the online and mobile banking software. Okay, so this is a sample application that we have, which is an online and then the mobile banking application. So do you see here, the once I log in, it will show me all the details regarding the balance that is available. So all of you have your banking accounts, right? Bank of America, Wells Fargo, you have the different bank accounts. The moment you log in, what it shows you the details regarding your balance. So here also you can see the same thing. And then we have the banking, the users can be added, the marketplace, the personal, and so on. So there are a lot of different kind of functionalities. We call these as functionalities. For example, you click on the account summary and then the account summary will be displayed here. Scheduled payments, click on this and then another page for the payments that have been scheduled and then further operations will be displayed over here. So each of these are called as the functionalities. And then participants, there are different kinds of testing that you could do. You have to test the functionality of the software, performance of the software, a lot of different types of testing that you got to do, which will be discussed in detail in our regular sessions, regular QA course. All right. So as of now, since it is just a 4-day session, which is actually not sufficient for me to complete the entire QA course. So I'm supposed to give you some introduction about this course, what exactly happens with the project-based examples. So let me check here some more questions. And I've pasted the link on the chat box, participants. And yes, the username and password I just now showed in this showed on the screen, you could find it here itself. Shreya, if you're already done with the QA course, you have written a very lengthy message. Do one thing, send an email to me. Otherwise, call up H2K Infosys and I will help you. What does the static testing and dynamic testing mean? So Neelam, static means we just review the project documents to identify the errors because it could avoid a lot of future defects in the software. Dynamic testing means we actually run the software and check the behavior of the software. Okay. So Hari, for more details, you'll have to contact H2K Infosys. So participants, in today's session, this is what I had to discuss, all right? And then in our next session, and given the schedule here, right? So in our next session, participants, I will show you some testing tools over here and we will see how the testing could be done. So in today's class, we have understood some basic concepts of the software testing. I started with the basics of the software development because we wanted to understand where exactly the testing stands. And then what is the meaning of testing, the levels of testing, the ways of testing, testing team, testing steps, all right. And then I showed you two sample applications over here, the projects on which in the future classes I'll be showing how to do the testing. So in the third session, okay, I will take these examples and then I will show you step by step how the testing can be done. All right, step by step testing process I will show you in this day three. So today we have discussed some basic concepts of the testing. So basically as a QA, what is your role? The BA will give you the project related information and based on that you have to verify if the developer has developed the software accordingly, okay? BRD and specification both, yes, prepared by the business analyst. Sharmila, you can get the details from H2K Infosys. Yes, Ismail, more about that job details and all, I will mentioning on the day 4. So on the day 4, we'll discuss more about the courses that we provide in H2K Infosys, how you apply for the jobs, and then what are the training features, I will explain you on the day 4, okay? Test scenario means shrimp. We have the different functionalities or the main requirements to be tested, right? So we call it as a test scenario. Fine, participants. So this is what we had to discuss today. So it was nice interacting with all of you. We understood some basic concepts of the software testing. The next session will be tomorrow, participants, wherein I will show you some practical exercises using the different kinds of testing tools. So we'll have a look at, you know, what are the different testing tools that are available and then how they could be used for our testing purposes. Okay, fine then. So we'll close the session, participants. Thanks everyone. And everyone have a good day. One more thing, participants, if you have more questions, please call us on this number. For more details, please call us on this number and you can leave your questions there.